live, it's a lonely place. When you find out the ops ain't the only snakes, and your spouse only know what you don't erase. The world.
I find the NRA to be hard work. But the fact that they always think the answer is more guns. After Sandy Hook happened, the NRA said, and I quote, "None of this would have happened if the teachers had guns." I think they're forgetting what school was like. Does anyone remember that casual teacher that used to, whenever she came onto school, that relief teacher came, you and your friends would see her and go, "Oh, we're gonna make her cry." And then she'd stand in front of the class with a bit of chalk and her hands would be shaking. And you go, "You're never getting married, are you, miss? Never gonna happen for you." Then she'd get back to a 1967 Volkswagen Beetle, she'd be crying over the steering wheel, just, "Why don't they like me? Let's give that cut a gun and see how things work out."
What's up, YouTube? This is Thionic, and welcome back to my channel. Today I want to discuss the bill that Florida passed giving teachers guns and how a horrible idea that is. Just think back to when you was a kid back in school. Come on, just think back. You remember, now don't get me wrong, there were some teachers that everybody loved. You know, like that one teacher that everybody loved. You know, everybody got their favorite teacher. But, you know, you got some teachers that people hate, they can't stand, you know. They can't wait to go to their class and they're gonna just go in on this teacher, you know. You got those teachers. And you got some teachers that's just, you know, that's just, they shouldn't be teachers pretty much, you know. I don't know why they got into the field. They hate kids, they can't stand kids, you know, like they should never even became a teacher, you know. I remember there's a story about this woman. She had a disability child, right? A child with disability, you know, a handicapped kid. And she kept sending her kids to school, and they'd come back saying, her daughter would come back saying, "I don't want to go to school, mommy. I don't want to go to school no more." And the mom was like, "That's weird," you know. So she put a listening device in her baby's hair. And her daughter went to school, and she heard like the teacher just going in on these kids, calling these kids. And this is class of full of disability kids, and this teacher is like calling them every name in the book, calling them crybabies. And other teachers are like teaming up and like, you know, helping out, like they going in on these kids. And you hear about shit all the time. You hear about this shit all the time with teachers. No, teachers banging students. Hey, where was all these teachers at when I was in school? You know, like these, oh my God, yo, because I had some hot-ass teachers, man. Had some hot-ass teachers. But like I said, where was all these teachers at when I was in school? But you hear it all the time, you know, how these teachers are doing this, doing that, you know. They're cheating on their wives, or they, you know, living secret double lives and shit like that. Teachers are not some of the greatest people on planet Earth. Some are, but a lot of them ain't. That's with everything, like cops, doctors, you know, like you got a lot of good cops, you got a lot of bad cops, you got a lot of good doctors, a lot of bad doctors, you know, that's with everything. It's not just with teachers and stuff. But, you know, I wouldn't go out and give, you know, everybody a gun like they trying to do. Like, they got this thing in their head where more guns is the problem. Like, more guns is the solution. Like the more guns you have, the better, you know. But I do remember watching the episode, It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia, where they was trying to, they were trying to prove that, you know, it's easy to get a gun and this and that, which it wasn't. It took them forever to get a gun. And when they did get a gun, they put themselves in a situation where, like, oh, we got a gun now. But in the room, everybody else had a gun, and the situation diluted itself. You know, it died off because, hey, you got a gun, hey, we got guns too. But, you know, that's TV. It don't work like that in real life. But giving a teacher a gun with their mind state and what they got to deal with you got to be aware of what a teacher got to deal with on a day-to-day basis. And you know, I don't see why you gonna do the job of a teacher if you know the pay ain't good and this and all that, but they still go and do it, you know. But the stuff they go through on a daily basis, you know, it's they don't have a mindset to have a gun. And just think about the students who know that the teacher have a gun. Like, you gonna have some students that's gonna be on their best behavior. Like, they're gonna be, oh shit, the teacher got a gun, they might shoot us, you know, like, let's behave pretty good. But you gonna have the smart kids, you gonna have the smart ass kids saying, teacher can't shoot us. The teacher can't shoot us. Motherfuckers might shoot you, but if I was a teacher that had a gun, I'd shoot your ass, shit. Some of these students, shit. If I was teaching, I'd treat the teacher the way I used to, you know, treat teachers and shit. Oh, yeah, I probably let off a warning shot to scare these fucking kids and shit. But I can see it already, you know, teachers, you know, leaving their guns behind and somebody getting it, or they, you know, left the gun unlocked at home and their kids or somebody, or one of their loved ones got into it, or a student got it, or altercation broke out and, you know, they got it. Or a school, God forbid, a school shooting actually happens. Okay, let's just say a school shooting happens, right? Some crazy motherfucker coming up with AK-47, letting loose on a bunch of kids and a bunch of students and shit. Now, these teachers got guns and shit. Now, so not only do this motherfucker got a gun, but now these teachers got guns and shit. Now, we having a shootout in a motherfucking school with all these kids and shit at. Now, let's just say a teacher want to be, you know, Mr. Save Everybody, you know, Superman and shit. And he said, I'm going to use my gun to save everybody. And he fucking, you know, end up shooting some kids by accident. Like, how would that whole thing? I can see it already. It's going to happen. It's going to be an incident where a teacher was trying to protect the school and shit went horribly wrong. It's going to be incidents where teacher's gun accidentally went off. There's going to be, it's some incidents waiting to happen where they're going to start. It's just so many, it's just so much that's, just think about it. Think about your worst experience you had with a teacher. Now put a gun in the middle of that. Like, it's, teachers get into it with each other. Teachers get into it with other teachers. It's I can't believe they passed that bill. The bill has passed in Florida. But they say this about Florida all the time. Florida is like the weird uncle of like the states or some shit like that. It's something weird or crazy always happening in Florida. Like, Florida is known for like crazy shit happening. But in other news, well, lack of other news, you know, talking about Call of Duty and this update that they just had, like, what the fuck was it? What the fuck was that? It was not even an update. I don't know what's going on with, you know, the whole Call of Duty community right now. Like, this is what I think is going on. I think, you remember the whole thing that happens with the first Call of Duty team, how they split up, but we didn't find out until like months later. I think it was months later. We didn't find out until like way later, until after that shit happened. We like, they left and started Respawn Entertainment. I'm thinking a similar situation happened here, and that's why we're seeing like the lack of updates and like the lack of, you know, the support, you know, with this Call of Duty game. And I feel bad if you bought this season pass. Like, oh my god, like, if you bought this season pass, that was a waste of money. It really was. But we have a sneak peek at, you know, with the next operation. It's probably gonna be called Armed and Ready. I'm gonna put it up on the screen so y'all can see the sneak peek too. But I think it's called Armed and Ready. Or that's like, they hitting that, or what is it gonna be? You know, we got Spectrum coming, you know, the Spectrum, whatever this dude name, with the blades and the invisibility and shit. They talking about he might have a C4, which that don't make no sense at all. I heard he gonna have a C4 smoke bomb or something. But I highly doubt he's gonna have a C4. They say he might have a C4. The whole smoke bomb, that seems more like it, it fits into, you know, his whole little style. And you know his specialty is gonna be his little, you know, little blade thing, you know, Jack the Ripper and stuff like that. But I'm really disappointed in Call of Duty this year. Now, I thought Black Ops 4 Treyarch was gonna be the one, you know, to bring it all back, you know, to the Call of Duty savior. That's what Treyarch posted had been. But it's Call of Duty, man. It's sad, the state of Call of Duty. You know, this game first came out, it was so good. I ain't gonna lie, I was in love in the honeymoon phase, man. This game couldn't do no wrong. Even with the specialist, man, like, it was irritating, but it wasn't that irritating, you know. And I thought with the whole bare bones playlist, I thought that would have made, you know, brought back the whole enjoyment of Call of Duty, which it did for a little bit, but bare bones is missing something. It just is. You know, it's missing something, like these updates, you know, like they care more about Blackout than they do MP, you know, multiplayer. Like, multiplayer gets no love. That's why I'm so glad that the new Call of Duty is not gonna have Battle Royale. That means they can focus more on multiplayer and less, you know, on this whole Battle Royale thing. And hopefully they don't go down this whole cosmetic thing, because cosmetic only is really bad for video gaming. Because the cosmetic is supposed to be there for something for you to grind for. Like, you're supposed to grind, you know, for those cosmetics, man. You know, like, and like any other game, like, if you want, like, I remember, like, a Call of Duty game, not Call of Duty, but a Spider-Man game back in the day, like, the more you played it, the more you beat it, you unlock new suits. You know, sometimes the suits do different things, but majority of it was just a cosmetic change, and that made a big difference, you know. But they really need to come on with it. We supposed to be promised a new Blackout character. We supposed to be promised a new sniper rifle. We didn't get none of this. But the video is coming to an end. I am Thionic, and I'm signing out. Peace. Oh yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos. Like I said, this is Thionic, and I'm signing out. Peace.